catch up with Ivana.
I first saw our next guest work over a decade ago online. She was in Australia at the time, although she grew up in Slovakia. When asked, though, she's truly a world citizen who lives everywhere. She's always tattooed. She's, to the best of my knowledge, hasn't had any other job. If you follow her work, it's her style is constantly evolving, but there's a signature that's always there because you could tell that it's her work. You definitely want to check out her awesome YouTube channel. It's filled with professional videos. She's taught seminars and has recently been working on merchandising her artwork, which we'll get into a little bit. She tattoos at friends' studios all around the world, so you can catch up with her on her website to see where she is. And it's always fun to catch up with her in person. She's got an amazing tattoo sleeve from Boris, and always schools me in a sense of style. I'm very honored to be speaking with Ivana. You can find her at Ivana Tattoo Art and at Ivana Tattoo Art on Instagram. Thanks for taking the time to do this interview.
Thank you.
Absolutely. So we'll start off with a simple lowball question. You know, what do you love most about tattooing?
I love the connection between, when it comes to skin is my absolutely favorite medium. So I like that life connection between my clients, pretty much. That's my absolutely favorite. And it's always different. I never know what to expect. I never know what to get. It's always challenging. And like I said, it's always different. Yeah. So I think that's my probably favorite. And like I said, the connection especially.
It's do you find yourself being part of a larger story with your clients?
Okay, I mean connection, because every person for me has different energy. Mm. And that's what I find very interesting. And I feel that I feel very honored, for example, to tattoo somebody for life or create something for them so suitable. That's when I talk about connection, this is part of it.
Yeah, I mean, for me, watching the magic of a tattooer helping the client kind of become who they want to be.
Absolutely, I'm just making statement piece for them, whatever is suitable for them, something that represents them. It's their work, and I never repeat my tattoos. Mm-hmm. I cannot even actually copy myself or repeat after myself, because I love to create something spontaneous at the moment. Mm-hmm. So exactly how I feel or how everything goes, that's what's gonna happen, and that's the statement piece my client's gonna wear.
Yeah, cool. So let's maybe, can we talk about the process? I know there's other videos where you talk about it, but maybe talk about that process a little bit. So a client comes to you, you know, what's the best process look like for you?
The best process for me, my client, I only do consultations by email, but my consultation is tell me one, two words, that's it. If you want to a little bit include something, if it is some particular elements you would like to put there, because some people like to combine, let's say, a few things together, but I don't need too much because I get overwhelmed. So just let's keep it very simple and clean. So let's say my client say, okay, I want a portrait of this animal. And I'm like, okay, tell me particular animal and that's all. Mm-hmm. And I will go from there. So I prepare references online. And when I see the client, that's how the colors comes to me. Mm-hmm. That's how the dynamic of the piece comes to me. So I really don't prepare anything in advance. I only need references, that's all. Mm-hmm. So I can get better ideas. Sometimes I have to do my search, obviously, like somebody tells me, oh, I want to get, I don't know, maybe like some animal, but I don't know anything about this animal or some particular piece of something. So I will search a little bit so I know exactly what is it. Mm. So I can have a better description or better imagination of the particular picture or piece. And I will go from there. So I will, let's say 5-10 images. And when I see my client, I can see the colors. I can see how my clients, I can just fill it out. And based on that, I will match colors. I will match the dynamic of the piece. Sometimes it can be more whimsical and playful. Sometimes it can be more bold. So it really, really depends how I feel about a particular client. That's how I do all of my tattoos.
And how much do they get to see of the finished design beforehand? They don't. They're putting their trust in you.
They don't see anything. They trust me, and I'm very lucky with my clients, because I think because of my style, it's a little bit I can say unique or different.
Sure.
And it's very specific. So for this reason, the clients I'm attracting, they are more open-minded, or it's like this group of people, you know, like how they say, like you attract your own tribe. Mm-hmm. So when they come to me, they already have the idea, just, okay, we just leave it up to you, like, you know. And sometimes I can pick placement, sometimes I pick the size. Actually, most of the cases, placement I can be flexible, of course, because some people don't want to have it like too seen or something. Sure. So we can talk about it, but most of the time, really, my clients give me absolute freedom.
Awesome. Very fun.
So they don't know what...
How long did it take for you to build a clientele that was that trusted you like that?
I would say for the past 5 years. I'm tattooing about 19 years now.
So what year did you start?
Around 2000 maybe.
Previously.
Or 1999. I don't remember. It was around 2000. So maybe I'm tattooing maybe around 18, 19 years.
Yeah, cool. And so you're self-taught. I mean, imagine that you pick up techniques when you're guesting with other tattooers and sharing. But for the most part, did you ever go to art school or?
No, I never had any formal art training, or I never did any art school. I used to draw since I was a child, just for fun. And sure. Later on, I used to do graffiti. Always drawing in the school. Always drawing. That was kind of my hobby, or really what I something enjoy. And right about when I was finishing school, tattooing just came to me. My friend got me tattooed, and she's like, "Do you want to try how to tattoo?" I was like, "Sure." That was it for me. So right about I finished my school, I did my the graduation, or I didn't know.
Graduation.
Yeah. So I did all of my school. I started to tattoo my friends, my family, and that was it for me.
And this is in Slovakia?
That was in Slovakia, in Slovakia, and I didn't know anything about like how to put machine together. Actually, it was machine for permanent makeup. It wasn't even particularly for tattooing. It had one coil, and I didn't know that I have to replace needles. I was thinking, one needle is good enough for like whatever, you know? So the skin was bleeding, and it was just a mess a little bit, and I didn't have gloves. Like, I don't know anything about hygiene at that point.
Sure.
And there wasn't tattoo studios. So I couldn't learn from anybody, and... in Slovakia at that time, some of my friends, they were going to Germany, so I was like, "Can you please bring me some tattoo magazine?" Uh-huh. So sometimes they bought me some tattoo magazine, and that's how I saw like how the machine is built, how to put the rubbers around the needle and everything. So somehow I put it together, and it took me just longer to figure it out everything. And later on, of course, I visited like overseas, some tattoo studios. Mm. So I was trying to look and ask the questions, and that's how basically I improved.
What were some of those first studios you visited?
It was in Czech Republic. This particular one, I forgot the name of it. It was, like I said, many years ago. But there was this nice guy, and I was asking him, like, "Can you please like give me a little like advice on how to like set up machine properly and how it works?" So he showed me. He was tattooing that time. He was working, but he was kind enough to show me how the machine works and everything for a few minutes. And that was, for me, of course, game changer. Like, okay, I got it now.
So imagine it's always a constant evolution of technical abilities.
Oh, absolutely. That time, because it's very different. That time when I used to use coil machine, I used to do my own needles. I used to set up my machines. Every particular like scheme was different, so I have to learn how to set up machine. But that was all nice. You know, I cannot even compare it now with these new rotary machines. It's so easy. It's like drawing with a pen, basically.
Sure. No, the technology and its impact on the tattoo world is amazing. Do you use many computers for your design process, or are you still stay like you're drawing mostly on the skin? But as far as preparation goes, or
I think very old school. Like I said, I just find some image online, and even stencil I do by hand, because I don't know. I'm focusing more on shapes where I tattoo. So I don't have to have necessarily all the details. It's a little bit, combination of abstract and painting and whatever. So for me, it's the most important proportion. And I really like to work from the photograph, so I can see very sharply when it comes to, for example, animals or flowers or faces. I need to have the clearest image possible. So I'm looking for the large, high resolution images. And the rest, I draw it by hand directly, like, as I print it out. I draw it by hand, and then I'm just making it up on the skin.
Yeah,
so cool. When it comes to everything, like a shading, or if I need to add something there and backgrounds, I just make it up.
Nice. You do use computers. I remember when you come through to do guest spots, like it's almost seemed like you weren't done with your day until you're on your computer, you know, posting up your tattoos into the right spots. And imagine that for your merchandise, you're on the computer a bit, or do you work with other people that are computers?
I work with other people, because honestly, I don't know too much about computers. I'm just happy to do my emails and all of this, and I don't even want to spend much time on it. It's not my profession. So I work with four different designers. But what I do again old school, I just draw something on the paper, or I do kind of like a collage. I cut it, I print out something, I cut it, and I write down what I desire, or I just explain to them what I desire to achieve, what kind of look, and they will do it for me.
Awesome. And then what kind of, I saw stickers when we were in Vegas. What other types of merchandise are you creating these days?
So right now I created ITA Los Angeles. It's a clothing company, and I'm having my first sweats right now, and the t-shirts and the hats. That's everything is out already. I don't have it on website yet except hats, but the sweats and everything, it is for sale, but people would have to direct message me on Instagram or send me email on info@ivanatattooart.com. I have a few different styles, a few different washes, few different cuts, few different designs. As of now, I released 3 different designs. It's a torn heart, biomechanical heart, and leopard. And yeah, so it's more like a contemporary high street fashion. Those are also more expensive pieces because the process it took me over 1 year just to create it and find the proper company, and everything had to be on point. So it's like these trays, and it was like a few different procedures how to do it. And the t-shirts I have, Just Love. So I published book 1 year ago, Just Love Tattoos and Sushi. So I created kind of merchandise come with it. So I have the t-shirts, I have hats, I have again like stickers, temporary tattoos. I'm gonna have a keychains. So the latest one for me is the clothing, and I'm definitely going to take up on this direction. That's pretty much what I'm spending the most time right now. Hopefully next year everything should be like nice and on the website and properly. With the merchandise, I have enamel pins, I have temporary tattoos, I have stickers, I have books, I have art prints. So there is lots of other stuff also coming in the future for the next year, but this is just like little stuff I created on the way.
Awesome. They all look great. Like I said, what I saw in Vegas, the colors are very bright, and it, you could tell that you're taking the care to make sure that the ingredients that go into the merchandise are top shelf.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Everything what I create has to be absolutely top shelf. So
yeah, it's very exciting. Yeah.
And everything is made in US also. So I'm not working with any other companies besides here.
Oh, that's awesome. I do everything here. Yeah. Oh, and all the clothing too?
Everything I make here. So I have full control over it. If I need something, I just go there in person. I created my hats before or on the t-shirts. Mm-hmm. I'm still doing the labor work on them. So.
Oh, crazy. Awesome.
Ivana's inspiration is infectious. The power of positivity and love combined with direction and focus. Again, truly inspiring.